going to talk a little bit about facial analysis and how we determine where we put product when we're doing treatment for Botox for dynamic rhytids of the face. So when you're analyzing a patient, the first thing you want to do is a full facial analysis. After you identify the problems that they are concerned about, you want to make sure that you can offer an appropriate correction for those issues. So as we look at Helen here and try to identify a couple of things that we could potentially improve upon with a neuromodulator such as Botox, we want to try to identify a couple of different physical exam findings. So just ask her to elevate her brow. So recall that the elevation of the brow is primarily by the frontalis, and it's the only muscle that allows appropriate brow elevation. So if a patient comes in, particularly an older patient, complaining of horizontal rhytids in their face, one of the things you have to discuss with them is their expectation of a smooth forehead. So typical treatments in the glabella region, we're probably going to not need as high a concentration for her because we didn't have a whole lot of corrugator activity, would be approximately 20 to 25 units. I tend to inject those in 5-unit aliquots in the central region of the face. And so what I'll tend to do is just pinch the brow in this region and remind the patient that they need to breathe. And then a small stick here. As close to possible, you want to put the product in at around 90 degrees. You don't want to come in at a tangential angle because you're trying to place this product directly in the muscle you're trying to affect. All right, so do pressure there for just a second, let her catch her breath, and then we'll treat in the lateral orbicularis oculi region. I tend to do injections in 2.5-unit aliquots on the lateral aspect of the orbit. It's important to remind you that if you are in the orbital skin, that the skin Deep to the skin, you're going to find the muscle. There's not subcutaneous tissue there, so you're going to raise a wheel akin to what you would for a TB test. So you're going to want to try to stay very superficial in the skin when you're addressing the area over here. Push your head against my hand a little bit. Good. So that just creates a little bit of tension. And I'm putting in just 2.5-unit aliquots in this area here.